Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to tell you the second royal king, Har Rai Ji. The name has a lot of meaning behind. So Har Rai mean, who is the Har mean God, Rai mean the royal king. So he is the ruler of the souls. So he was the one in secular rules. When you rule over people, you suppress them. You give them orders. In the spiritual sense, when you rule, you do not give them order, just the opposite. You serve them. So he served people, and by doing that, he also hit their conscience. Remember that the royal kings, they look after the crop or the building which the other Satgurus have built. So they protect it, and they give it all the assistance, or they keep it under their hand. Protection they give them. So the royal king, Har Rai Ji, he was so humble and so merciful that even one day, he was coming to see his father, Har Rai Ji, Har Gobind Ji, and his shirt touched a flower, and the flower fell down. That means it died, you know. So he was so ashamed that, I have made the flower to come down with the shirt. So next time, what he used to do, he used to tuck his shirt up so it does not flow around freely, so that it won't make another flower to come off. So this is the extent of, I can say, his mercy. So he used to go hunting, as every royal king did. So when he was going hunting, he would bring wounded animals to town and looked after them. He made a zoo in Amritsar. So that zoo, he will put them in there and make them live comfortably. That means taking the misery out of their life. Same way, he opened hospitals for the sick, in which the sick lost the misery of the sick were taken away, they were healed, and they went happily home. So all this was done without any partiality. Anybody is, all is welcome. Even one of the emperor's son was sick, and they could not get him healed anywhere. So they sent for some medicine from the storeroom of Sache Pasha Har Rai Ji. So he gave the medicine to that man free, and that healed the emperor's son. But still, after that healing and all that, it was not appreciated by the emperor. Still, they became the staunch enemy of royal kings. So that means those people, they have lost the salt. So when a person or a salt is lost, then cannot be regained. It is to become useless, that is to be thrown away out into the street for people to trample over them. Now what is salt then? Most of these dog colored people, they will think, oh, this cooking salt is the salt which Christ Jesus was talking. It is not that cooking salt he was talking. When Christ Jesus said to his laborers that you are the salt of the earth. Salt of the earth means that the Adam was created out of clay. And they represented Adam in their covenant, or Abraham. So when John the Baptist, he was baptizing men in water, he was doing so in the name of Abraham. So when they became the sons of Abraham, so they had the shame, or they have to keep the honor of Abraham intact. Abraham was a great man, righteous person. Well, that's why the first bishop who is to teach the moral laws to the people to make them conscience, that make them their conscience to be clean so that they can appreciate the good work. So he was the one bishop was baptizing men in water, but not the apostles. And when the bishop was baptizing them, he baptized them in the name of Abraham, not in the name of God the Father and all that. This had been brought up as a corruption by these dog-collared bishops and priests. So these people who had misled them, and who are the book people in the universities, they cannot know these things of gospel. Gospel is by revelation. They seek not the revelation, they seek the book knowledge. So let the dead bury their dead. That is what they are doing in the universities. They are dead in spirit, just arguing over the letters without understanding. Hardly any one of these university professors know what the Son of Man mean and how to become a Son of Man. So when the people were baptized in the name of Abraham, so they became the salt of Abraham. Whereas those people who were the Jews of the physical body, they had broken their covenant with Abraham, so they became saltless people. So that's why Jesus never took those people as laborers, only those which were the salt of Abraham. So in the later on I will be describing a very important saying in our Holy Bible, which says, you know, in the Punjabi I will say a little bit, Mitti Musalman di Pai Pede Khamyar. Mitti means the soil or the clay of the Musalman, mean one who is a firm believer in Allah. So remember that when you represent your forefathers, then you are a Mitti of the Musalman, then you are the raw or the green brick that can be baked into a Musalman. But if you break your covenant with your tribal elders, then you become a brick, raw brick, which is not molded by the, which is unfaithful to the tribal fathers, which is the not molded by the heavenly father, but by the Satan. He converted them. Remember the parable of wheat and tare. Satan and came night, converted wheat plant into tears. God bless you.